So far, we've only worked with very simple, basic forms that aren't combined with any other forms. So we need to move on to drawing actual objects. And the way we do that is by combining the four basic forms that we know into a realistic looking object. So I'm going to draw a vase here. And it has several basic component forms. The first one I'm going to do is this is a cylinder. And I use the cylinder because the base of it and the top of it are about the same size. So if I draw a cylinder, I can kind of find the top and bottom very quickly. Next, I'll draw a sort of rounded part. It's not a perfect sphere, but it's close. So I'll use a sphere-ish kind of form to do that. And what I can do is I can check the width of the sphere against the width of the cylinder and make sure that it's symmetrical on both sides. And that's why you see these repeated vertical lines. The next thing that I do is draw an ellipse where the spherish form and the cylinder meet. And you'll notice that what I do throughout this whole process is go through and use measuring lines and axes to kind of keep the symmetry going. You'll see now I have a central axis, so I can measure the symmetry on both sides. And the neck of this vase is kind of two cones stacked on top of each other and inverting. So I'm going to start with this inverted cone from the mouth and bring that down. The next thing that I'm going to do is do the opposite. I'm going to bring a cone that's right side up from the connection of the cylinder and the spherical part, and then I can connect the two cones with a little bit of an ellipse in the middle of them. Then what I can do is, because this isn't a sharp distinction from cone to spherical element, I can round out that a little bit. Then what I'm going to do is work and be very careful on the outer edges of this form. Because the symmetry kind of has to be fairly perfect, you will need to really examine working side to side on the form how well that you've created the outer edges in symmetry. And one of the things that that I learned how to do relatively early on in drawing was to work side to side on the form. So if you do something to the left side of the form, you immediately switch to the right side and do that. So you'll see that if I work on the left side, I switch back and work on the right side. If I work on the shadow core on the right side, I go back and refine something on the left. So you're constantly bouncing back and forth, skipping around from edge to edge of the form to kind of create these component shapes and put them together into something that's recognizable as a vase in its line structure.